Hi students, in today's session I am going to explain the chemical properties of alkali metals from chapter 5 alkali and alkaline earth metals. So first, what is chemical properties of alkali metals? So here, alkali metals exhibit high chemical reactivity. The reactivity of alkali metals increases from lithium to cesium. So lithium, sodium, rubidium, cesium, francium, so everything you know. So here the reactivity of alkali metals increases from lithium to cesium. So since the ionization energy decreases down the group. So first, alkali metal reactivity of alkali metals. So reactivity of alkali metals lithium to cesium. So that is increases. So reactivity capacity of alkali metals, that is increases. At the same time, ionization energy is automatically decreases. And next one is, all alkali metals are highly reactive towards the more electronegative element such as oxygen and halogens. Some characteristics chemical properties of alkali metals are described now. The first one is reaction with oxygen, and next one is reaction with hydrogen, and then reaction with halogen, and reaction with liquid ammonia, and reaction with water, and reducing activity, and reaction with carbon. Okay, so first let us see a reaction with oxygen. So all the alkali metals on exposure to air or oxygen burn vigorously. Vigorously means so very fast, so forming oxides of their surface. So lithium forms only monoxide. So everything oxides of the surface. So surface only oxides layers only form, but lithium forms only monoxide. Sodium forms the monoxide and peroxide, and the other elements form monoxide, peroxide and superoxides. So these oxides are basic in nature. So what is the first one? Lithium. So lithium forms only monoxide. So lithium forms only monoxide. And next one is sodium. So sodium forms the monoxide and peroxide. So sodium forms monoxide and peroxide. And then next one, and the other elements form monoxide, peroxide and superoxides. So these oxides are basic in nature. So first we take lithium. So lithium is reacted with oxygen. So here simple oxide is formed. So what is the formula for lithium? Li. So that is reacted with oxygen. So here only simple oxide is formed. So what is that simple oxide? Lithium oxide. So lithium oxide formed Li2O. So that is lithium oxide. So how is balanced the equation? So here you take 4 times mean. So now you take 2 times. So 2 times of 4. So 4 times of lithium. Oxygen 2 times. So here also oxygen 2 times. So lithium oxide is formed. And next one is sodium is reacted with oxygen to form peroxide. So what is the formula for sodium? Ni. So that is reacted with oxygen. So sodium reacted with oxygen gives peroxide. So it gives sodium peroxide. Sodium peroxide forming Na2O. So here sodium 2 times. So Na became 2 times of sodium. So 2 times of Na and O2, that is sodium peroxide. And next one is any metals, other metals. That is potassium, rubidium and cesium. So M represents potassium, rubidium and cesium. So metal, this metal is reacted with oxygen to give NO2. So that is superoxides. So M represents potassium,
rubidium and cesium. So this is superoxide MO2.
So here you have present potassium, rubidium and next one is cesium. So lithium is reacted with oxygen to give lithium oxide, so that is simple oxide. And sodium is reacted with oxygen, sodium peroxide is formed. And metals like potassium, rubidium and cesium react with oxygen, it gives superoxides. And then next one, reaction with hydrogen. All alkali metals react with hydrogen at above 673 Kelvin, so lithium at 1073 Kelvin, to form the corresponding ionic hydrides. So reactivity of alkali metals with hydrogen decreases from lithium to cesium. Okay, let us see the equation. Metal plus hydrogen.
Metal plus hydrogen. It gives N plus
and hydrogen. So hydrogen is a negative, that is hydride is pumped here. So H minus.
So what is M?
So here are two types of hydrogen. So we take two types of metal.
So two types of N plus and H minus is pumped.
Okay, so what is M? M represent lithium, sodium,
potassium, rubidium and cesium.
And next one is the ionic character of the hydrides increases from lithium to cesium.
So ionic character of hydrides. So that is increases from lithium to cesium. Ionic character is
increases. And this stability decreases.
Ionic character increases stability. That is
decreases. So the hydrides behave as strong reducing agents and their reducing nature increases down the group.
So reducing nature
that is increases, not decreases,
that is increases.
Okay. And next one is reaction with halogen. Alkali metals combine readily with halogens to form ionic halides. So that is
reacted with X induce
MX. So that is ionic halides. So reactivity of alkali metals with halogen increases down the group because of corresponding decreasing ionization enthalpy. Okay, so alkali metals reactivity capacity increases down the group because the corresponding decreases in ionization enthalpy. So here you take metal that is reacted with halogen.
So halogen represents the symbol is
HX2, that is fluorine, iodine. So here, what is formed here?
Here two types of H, so two types of MX is formed.
So how is balanced the equation?
M is two times, so here you take two types of M.
Okay, so here M represents what is that?
So M represents as usual. That is alkali metals lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium and cesium. And they represent fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine.
And the next one, all metal halides are ionic crystals. However, lithium oxide, lithium iodide shows covalent character as it is the smallest cation that exerts high polarizing power on the iodide anion. So additionally, the iodide ion being the largest can be polarized to a greater extent by lithium ion. And next one is, that's all for reaction with halogen. And next one, reaction with liquid ammonia. Alkali metals dissolve in liquid ammonia to give deep blue solution that are conducting in nature. So the conductivity is similar to that of pure metals. So the specific conductivity of mercury is 10^4 and the sodium in liquid ammonia is 0.5 × 10^4. So this happens because the alkali metal atom readily loses its valence electron in ammonia solution. Both the cation and the electron are ammoniated to give ammoniated cation and ammoniated electron. The blue color of the solution is due to the ammoniated electron, which absorbs energy in the visible region of light and thus imparts blue color to the solution. The solutions are paramagnetic and are standing slowly liberate hydrogen, resulting in the formation of an amide. So in concentrated solution, the blue color changes to bronze color and become diamagnetic. Let us see the equation.
M x plus y of ammonia, it gives M NH3x times plus E NH3y times. So that's electron. Our next equation, metal that is reacted with the electron in the presence of ammonia. So it is formed M NH2 type. So remaining one hydrogen is present. That hydrogen like H2. So cancel this only one hydrogen is remaining. Okay, so that's all for chemical properties of alkali metals. Thank you, students.